Hey, horse people. This is a sad video. So I'm not going to share where the video's at because I know people can be mean and they might go hate on this person. But this horse, according to owner, she thinks it was strangled by this blanket. I don't know if it was strangled or died of exhaustion and fear. When horses get trapped, sometimes they will fight and fight and fight and just wear themselves out, which sometimes causes colic. They can twist a gut. So without knowing for sure whether this is strangulation, this was a blanket, and a lot of people blanket their horses. I'm not a big fan of it. I don't do it unless a horse is shivering. Now, this horse is 30 years old. I don't know how bad the weather is. I'm not here to make this an issue about the owner is good or bad. I'm not a blanket fan. I think it makes horses sweat. This horse looks like it's got a good coat. I don't know if it needed a blanket. When you put a blanket on, if it rains, it gets wet. It makes the horse twice as cold as if he didn't have a blanket at all. People put blankets on and they don't either fit them right or make sure they're connected right. And even if they are connected right, if a strap breaks, it gets caught on a fence, it gets caught on a tree. It looks like this hoof got in between a strap. Or maybe the blanket got pulled around and a horse panicked and pulled and it twisted the blanket. And then it pulled on the leg, so the leg started kicking and it just, it's really hard to say. She did a little video of it. Obviously, rigor mortis has set in. I don't know how long it's been down. The blanket through the leg there, this strap, some people will cross the straps between the legs, other people's don't. This horse, my guess is, was panicking. This hoof looks pretty long to me, this much hoof wall. I mean, on the outside of the hoof, it doesn't look that long, but on the inside, man, that looks like a really long hoof wall. I'm surprised this hasn't chipped off because the hoof wall gets weak. But so this hoof right here looks kind of long. When I say long, the sole is way up here. So all this is hoof wall. Kind of see right here, this hoof is kind of coming around. Some people do their hooves different. I'm not, so this one doesn't look, this hoof doesn't look that bad. Yeah, so see this hoof, I mean, this hoof looks a little long, it's a little chipped. But the sole is right here, so you don't have a whole bunch. You got a little bit of hoof wall here that's kind of long. These heels look really long to me. Some people say I put my heels too short. Other people tell me my heels are left too long. So it's kind of just an eye, but this blanket, you can tell it's strapped around. The horse probably panicked and fought. Maybe wore itself out. Maybe had a heart attack. Maybe colicked. Maybe strangled. It's hard to say. But anytime you have a horse, now the horse is 30 years old, so maybe that's why it had the blanket. Again, anytime you put blankets or halters on a horse, I've got plenty of videos to where horses die with halters on in a pasture because owners are too stupid or lazy to learn how to catch their horse, so they leave halters on. That is the most dangerous and irresponsible thing you can do as a horse owner. And I know I'm going to have some people here defending it and saying, I have to be able to get my horse and it could be an emergency and nobody else can catch them. And they'll have all these reasons. And then when their horse shows up dead, they'll be like, oh, stupid horse, it got caught up. There'll be somebody saying, hey, this stupid horse tore up their blanket. That's their fault. The blanket was there to protect them. It's never the horse's fault. This is sad. Be aware of blanket dangers and halter dangers. It will... It can kill your horse. So I'm glad this person shared it. It can be dangerous. It's not good. But, I mean, things happen. All right. Well, then that there on dangers of blankets and halters in a pasture. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boy, so is Ransom.